now work with them to put in an underwater connector onto the buoy that then allows us to put an underwater cable down to the ocean floor so we can then connect a whole bunch of underwater sensors. So what that gives you now is a seabed to sort of mid-air system that can do sensing for all things below, at, and above the surface of the ocean.
Hey, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. Joining me now is Philipp Stratmann. He is the CEO of Ocean Power Technologies. And Philipp, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Yeah, good to see you, Steve. Thanks for having me on again.
Yeah, so another contract announced. So this is actually an additional contract with the Naval Postgraduate School in California. And maybe sort of take us back a step and talk a little bit about the first deployment of this one and now the new one and really what that means for the company.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, as we said, you know, last week, we've got more exciting things coming. And if you know, you recall, earlier this year, we had announced that we were working with AT&T and the Naval Postgraduate School on the deployment of one of our power buoys to demonstrate the ability to relay 5G signals under 5G at sea out into the ocean as part of kind of that multi-domain, multi-asset drone integration that Naval Postgraduate School was working on. We've been working with them and their partners over in the region on the permitting. And this latest contract builds on that. But what it now does, in addition to all the surface materials that we've developed and we have previously talked about, you know, maritime domain awareness solutions, the AI-enabled Merrows suite, we've now worked with them to put in an underwater connector onto the buoy that then allows us to put an underwater cable down to the ocean floor so we can then connect a whole bunch of underwater sensors. So what that gives you now is a seabed to sort of mid-air system that can do sensing for all things below, at, and above the surface of the ocean, and doing that through a high-speed 5G network. I think that's a pretty exciting development and one we're very excited to put out into the ocean.
And this obviously acts as zero carbon as well. That's the other key part of this, right?
Yeah, and as you can see, it's we are utilizing our power buoy systems, which have the wave energy converter system on the inside. You have the ability to add solar panels. You have the ability to add small wind turbines. So what that gives you is a zero carbon system that does all the sensing that traditionally would have had to be done either through putting out a ship that's burning diesel and or bunker fuel out there, which obviously creates carbon emissions, or putting long cables down on the seabed, which disturbs sea life and kind of the ocean floor in general. What this enables you to do is putting out systems that have zero carbon emissions to do all the sensing and give you 24/7 access, and at the same time have very low noise signatures or heat signatures. So it really becomes zero carbon and low disturbance in the ocean to do all the sensing that you may want to do.
So, Philipp, who would benefit from something like this? Obviously, you talked about, the potential in the military side of things, and there is that, being able to have that connectivity out in the middle of the ocean. But are there others that could benefit from this? And does it always have to, can it be closer to shore and be utilized in a different way?
No, so there's definitely others that would benefit from it. You know, if you're stepping out of the military but staying on the defense or that security side of it, you can, Coast Guard would benefit from this. You would look at local law enforcement that are trying to patrol along the beaches during the summer. But then you're moving into the offshore energy and the conservation space. This would enable you to do very efficient tracking of whales that are going up and down the coastline, particularly where there's offshore construction for wind farms. It would enable you to do enforcement of the national marine sanctuaries that we have, which are essentially marine protected areas where nobody's supposed to go in and out and nobody's supposed to do any fishing, but they're very hard to enforce. So this gives you actual monitoring of what goes on there. And then you don't have to be close to shore because you could use a series of these as repeater stations. So you end up bouncing a signal along a daisy chain of buoys that then give you a broader network for communications and data to really look at conservation, prevention of illegal fishing, keeping the general public safe, and obviously, as we discussed earlier, the military side. And I think the other thing you could look at is during times of high activity is water quality sensing. looking of the beaches on the Atlantic coast in the United States. During the summer month, you could put these systems out there and you get real live water quality alerts. So you can avoid anybody, being impacted by some kind of sewage outflow that shouldn't have occurred.
Yeah, maybe have that in Paris in the Seine River when, during the
I
Olympics
think
would
they I think they
be
could have definitely benefited from that. So
good. Absolutely. Well, fascinating stuff. And invite people to head to the website for the company and take a look at some of the stuff that you are doing, because it really is interesting. And this is another fascinating one as well. So, Philip, thank you so much. A good update, and congratulations on this one.
thank you, Stephen. I appreciate having us on, and we look forward to talking about more in the future.
All right, look forward to it. Philipp Stratmann, the CEO of Ocean Power Technologies.